I'm delighted to welcome Jeff Keith of Tesla to Dawn Osborne in session. Jeff, let everyone know how you're doing.
Doing fantastic, Dawn, and hope you are too, and everybody else.
Now, you've just released an Aerosmith song as a single, SOS Too Bad. Now, why did you choose that song?
Well, to pick an Aerosmith song, we wanted to pick one of our favorites, and that's definitely one of our favorites, you know, one of the older songs off of Get Your Wings. And we thought that would be a great one that fits Tesla to a T.
Did you hear on the grapevine what Joe or Stephen might have thought of it?
You know what? I haven't heard anything through the grapevine yet, but hopefully they're happy about it. And yeah.
Well, your voice is super distinctive. I mean, there's absolutely no mistaking you. I can't think of anyone else that sounds like you. When did you realize that your voice was so distinctive and that everybody would know who it was immediately?
You know what? I'm a late bloomer. My first concert was Day on the Green, number 3 in Oakland Coliseum in 1978. I was 19 years old. And as a matter of fact, Aerosmith was headlining. And then Foreigner, it was, you know, Van Halen opened the show. And then Bon Scott and AC/DC came out. And it was like, wow, who is this? And Pat Travers, and it was Foreigner. Right before Aerosmith headlining the show. That was my first concert ever. I was like blown away. And so, yeah. And then next, you know, I was like 24 years old when I joined City Kid. And before we released our first record in 86, I was 28. So I'm a late bloomer. It's a Cinderella story. I'm from a small town.
Well, you still look fantastic. We still got it after all of these years. Now the album that it's from, Full Throttle, it's a live album, but I couldn't hear the audience on the single the same way that I could hear on the rest of the album. Is the single actually live?
You know, I think we recorded it and we've been playing it live. Now, as far as for on the record, on this record, I'm not so sure. I thought it was live, but once again, Dawn, I'm just the guy they hand a microphone to. And when we're recording, I don't even know we're recording. It's the best way for me. It's just that way. It just got that live feel. But I'm not quite sure. I'm not the guy to ask for that. I wish I had the answer.
Okay. But the rest of it definitely is. And I believe it's from the Sturgis bike rally. Do you remember that gig?
Oh, yeah. Full Throttle Saloon. But it's an outdoor show. And it was a fantastic, great atmosphere. And, you know, all about motorcycles and rock and roll. And the recording came out great. And everybody's seeming to like it, and we're loving it for sure. And everything's good.
Now, the Sturgis bike rally, that sounds like a tough crowd. Are they a good crowd? They seem to love Tesla. How big is the crowd?
Oh, the crowd. Oh, it's a big crowd. Lots of motorcycles, like I said, but everybody's in the rock and roll mood, and it's a great vibe, and we captured it and put it out. And like I said, you know, long as we're having fun. And actually, Sturgis is a great crowd. Everybody's there for riding and rock and roll. And everything went great.
Okay. And the live recording itself, I know Frank does a lot of producing and things. Did you actually, like touch up the recording? Or is it, like, as it was on the night? Do you know?
We always keep it absolutely live. It's like the acoustic five-man acoustical jam. That was live from top to bottom. And that's how we like to do things and keeping it real. If it sounds good, that's us on a good day. And if it sounds bad, then that's us on a bad day.
You know,
but it's a real deal.
I thought I remembered that. And that's why I asked, because it's great. And also, Full Throttle, you say that's the name of the venue at Sturgis Bike Rally. But also, I think it refers to the fact that it's a very heavy set list. I mean, in some ways, it's not the obvious Tesla songs on the album.
What now? What song are you talking about? SOS? Too bad.
Well, no, I think generally the songs that are on the album. So you've got a heavy version of Miles Away, you've got Time to Rock, Cold Blue Steel, the new single as well. But I actually
Yeah.
think the way that you've delivered the songs, it was really heavy. I mean, I don't know whether that was aimed at the bike crowd or and why you chose those particular songs, not maybe what could have been a Tesla's greatest hits. But I know you've had previous live albums anyway.
Right. Well, so Cold Blue Steel and Time to Rock are our latest songs that we've written, and then Miles Away was off of Into the Now, which was a record we did on our own. So this was an opportunity to get a chance to put them out, on a record. And yeah, we enjoyed the songs that are on there. I'm looking at it right now. Oh yeah, some great stuff.
Do you still love touring?
Love it. Still having a blast almost 37 years later. And as long as we're having a blast, we're going to keep doing it.
Okay, that's fantastic. You look like you do. It's just that the first song, Miles Away, on the record, it's kind of sad about missing your family, really. So I guess there's some elements of it that, it's good with the bad.
Well, it's not about just focusing on the bad, but it's just an example of everybody thinks it's just like glamorous, and which it's great. There's a lot of glamorous moments, but there's a lot of moments also where we're just real people too. And so it's just keeping it real, keeping it real.
But I guess that Tesla is just like a second family to you now. I mean, after all these years, I guess in some ways you may have come to appreciate each other more because, not everybody has a chance to have so many original members in the band.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're brothers for sure. We're brothers, and we've been through things together that, we've only been through together with, I mean, nobody else. And just all the things that we've been through over the years and all the great moments. And so we're brothers out there. When we get up on stage, we're coming together as brothers, having fun, having a blast. People pick up on that. Then the crowds, and next it's full circle and everybody's just having a great time.
Well,
We're really enjoying it.
I guess it's hard to imagine life without the band at the moment, this point in time.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah,
Because,
except for COVID, that was a tough haul to go through. But we're back out there doing it, enjoying it, and having a ball, and couldn't be happier.
now, Tesla's one of the flagship bands on the Monsters of Rock cruise, and so are Kicks. And like literally in the last day or two, Kicks have hung up their microphones and their drumsticks and stuff. And this is their last gig. Now, whereas in a recent press release, Tesla said, "We're like old boots, we will endure." So, so I'm glad to hear that from the press release that there's, because I'm really sad about Kicks stopping, and I'm glad to hear that you're not planning to stop.
Yes. Hey, as long as my voice is holding up and everybody's doing good, we're going to keep it up and go as long as we can. I was sad to hear about Kicks throwing in a towel or however you want to call it, hanging the boots up. But Tesla, these boots were made for walking, and that's just what we'll do. Rocking. Not walking, rocking.
Absolutely, absolutely. And when you were 20, did you think that, you would do it for your whole life, that Tesla would be something that you would do for your whole life?
You never know how long things are going to go. I mean, we're just having fun making records, writing songs from the heart, and you just don't think about how long is it going to last. And it's still working. We're still having a blast, and so we're very fortunate for that.
When you write songs, is it still the same as it was?
Yeah, it's still writing songs from the heart. For me, I think about, yeah, make sure, with my on my vocal range, make sure it's in the right key, because back in the day, in the late 80s and stuff, in the early 90s, sometimes I'd get my melody up there, and then next, when we play live, I got to tune down a little bit. So I try to keep things more in my vocal range, and but still having fun writing from the heart.
Okay. And is there any new music on the way then? I mean, you have put out a couple of singles recently. Is this a precursor to a new studio album?
Yeah, we're thinking about making an album sometime in the future, hopefully not too far. But right now, we're just putting out singles, because that's these days, that's how you can do it. You can release things, and so people can download them. And we're getting ready to put out a new single early next year. And but yeah, sometime or another, we definitely want to make another record. Tessa likes to write songs. And we could get by with our catalog like some bands do, but we like writing songs. We love writing songs. So once we get enough for a record, we'll be releasing it.
Okay, that's good news. And I hear you have a Las Vegas residency coming up. That sounds very posh.
Yeah, no, it's fun. We did one in March, and we're doing one, I think it's September 29th through October 7th. It's at the House of Blues in Las Vegas. And we had a blast doing the last one, and we're gonna have a gas, gas, gas doing this one.
But I mean, Tesla is famous for keeping its boots on the ground, actually, for keeping it real with people and for being the people's band. And you've always done that, no matter how successful and how much money you've had. You've never forgotten that, you're there rocking out with the fans. And in a way, you don't put yourselves above them. You treat everybody like family, I guess.
Absolutely. We're just a hardworking blue collar rock band, and we're up there and we're representing the people that are out in the audience. We're just regular people too. We just happen to be up there and playing songs. And so, we're definitely a blue collar rock band, and that's what we have in the audience, is blue collar, hardworking people.
Now, I usually see you on Mork because you don't make it over to the UK that much. I was lucky enough to be in the audience at Abbey Road when you did the recent five-man jam in London, which was excellent.
Yes.
I know Brian had a blast because he absolutely loves the Beatles and they recorded there, of course.
Oh, yeah.
But do you think you will make it back again to the UK at any point? I mean, it's getting more expensive and more difficult to do now.
Yeah, that's the hardest part, is for us to go over there and be able to at least pay for the trip, and hopefully come home with to put food on the table. But that's the hardest part about going over there. And because the fans are there, and they're very appreciative, and we appreciate them very much, but it just costs sometimes. We went over there, and actually it cost us money to go over there, but at least we got to play to the fans. So hopefully we'll be able to get over there soon and be able to come home, like I said, put some food on the table for the family, and have fun with the fans. So hopefully we'll be coming over there soon.
That's excellent. And in the meantime, I'll just keep coming to Mark because I know you're going to turn up at some point. I don't think you're going in this year coming up, but because you announced that last time. So, but maybe the one after. Keep our fingers crossed for that. Is there anything that Tesla's planning next year that I haven't mentioned that you can talk about?
I know we're working on a new single to release maybe next spring, and hopefully, we get enough songs up to put out a new record. Hopefully that would be next year too.
Okay, that's fantastic. And have you been putting the plans together for that behind the scenes? I know you probably can't tell me anything about it.
Well, you mean for the next single?
For the next album, yeah.
Oh, for the next album. Yeah, well, we've got to put together enough songs to make a record. Like right now, it's sort of like back when people used to put out the 45 records, you know, you can download the singles and all that kind of stuff. So it's really oriented to for doing singles, but we're going to get enough put together for a record.
Okay, that's really good news, Jeff. Thank you so much for making some time to talk to us.
All right, thanks, Dawn.
And I'll see you next time at Mug.
All right, woo! Can't wait.
Thanks so much.